Everything's bigger in America, including our crash test dummies. Boy, that's depressing. Hey guys, Tara here for DNews, and with the rising rates of obesity here in America, an interesting topic has suddenly come to light. Crash test dummies. Recent research from the University of California found that obese drivers are 78% more likely to die in a car crash. And with over two-thirds of our population now classified as either obese or overweight, it makes sense that our crash test dummies should reflect that growing portion of the population. Well, buckle your seatbelts, because soon enough, they will. A company called Humanetics is currently developing an obese crash test dummy that weighs 273 pounds. That's compared to the current standard of 167 pounds. According to the company CEO Chris O'Connor, seat belts, airbags, and other safety features have all been designed so that your rear sits flush against the back of the seat, and the seat belt is tight against your pelvis. Obese people who have larger rears and more mass around their midsections tend to sit further forward, and the seat belts don't necessarily grasp around their pelvises as easily. So the new dummies, which were modeled after real human cadavers, will accurately reflect not just the weight, but the weight distribution of the average obese American. They'll also be slightly taller, since the population has grown slightly since the original crash test dummies were created in the 80s. The new dummies cost about $500,000 each, which is on par with the current models, but they also last forever. Not to mention the potential lives saved, which you can't really put a price on. Unsurprisingly, obese citizens aren't the only other model in development. Currently, there are models for teenagers and infants, which are already on the market. But Humanetics is also creating a line to reflect the aging elderly population, which will be released in 2015 along with the obese models. They're also looking at lines specifically designed for women. Many studies claim that female drivers have a much higher fatality rate than male drivers, which explains why one of the biggest research clinics at General Motors is specifically geared towards petite women, because they sit much closer to the steering wheel than the rest of the population. What do you guys think about this? I know it's super depressing to think about, but until we solve the obesity crisis, these problems are only gonna get bigger. Pun not intended. You can let us know your thoughts in the comments down below, and as always, thank you guys for watching.